Hey friends, welcome to socialbreakfast.com. So today I'm just for the rest of the week, I'm just doing some basic practical tips I'm giving you on social media. We officially start the social breakfast on Monday, the 12th April at 8 a.m. So go to socialbreakfast.com and book and get your link. You'll get the Zoom link. Share it with your mates as well. Share the website socialbreakfast.com with your friends, because they must get their own link. The benefits of the Zoom link is that you can interact with each other. We can share and network with each other. If you've got any questions, you can ask those questions on the live call. You can't do that on the Facebook. On the Facebook Live. So if you want to watch it on Facebook, you can add me as a friend on Facebook and you can watch it on my profile. Guys, for those guys who see this on Facebook, please hit the share button just below this video. You will see there's a share button. Share it to your friends. It helps your friends as well as it helps you when it comes to the algorithm. It will help you to get more reach as well, because social media is reciprocal. So the more you share, the more you interact, the more you engage, the more people are going to see you, and the more people are going to like your business. So let's start. Today's topic is something interesting. I'm started doing something new. I'm going to give you practical tips on how to be seen out there. How to improve your image online. So today we're going to be talking about how to add a WhatsApp link to your email signature. So I'm going to be showing you on two programs, on MS Outlook as well as Gmail. I'm going to show you step by step how to do it. So if you see this video on your timeline, hit the share button, because you can help somebody grow their business. So guys, welcome to socialbreakfast.com. So if you see this on Facebook, please share it, guys. Share it with your mates. Hit the share button. You don't know who you're going to help. So the agenda for today is about us, small about us, introduction, some social media stats. The topic is social media. The topic for today is how to create a WhatsApp link and how to insert that link into your email signature. And we also test, and I'll show you on my own email program how to do it. And then there's content ideas as well. That's the objective of this call. The main objective of this call daily is to give you content ideas so you show up on social media. Because if you are not showing up on social media, you're missing a big opportunity. So about us. Social breakfast. So we started this 2 years ago. It was to network and meet over a meal. We'll have a breakfast and we'll train you on a specific digital marketing tool, whether social media, online, email marketing, whatever it is. But it will be a specific tool that we used to meet in person. But we're waiting for lockdown to stop. So then we can start doing these in person. So I want to tell you about the challenge. Want to grow your business? Take the Resurrect Your Business Challenge. Turn around your business in 30 days. So guys, this is free. Starting on the 1st of May, we're going to start a challenge. For 30 days consecutively, we're going to have a challenge. It's free of charge. So invite your friends. In 30 days, you're going to get better sales. In 30 days, you're going to get better clients. In 30 days, you're going to get better exposure, better reach. Now, there's only 100 seats on the Zoom call, so make sure you book and you get that Zoom link. Now, somebody asked me, what do I mean by better clients? Listen, not every client is created equal. You get some clients who are tire kickers. They're going to waste your time. You want the fat cats. You want the guys with the big budgets. Somebody who's starting up, listen, they don't have budgets unless they've got angel investors and they've got venture capitalists. Most of the time, these startups don't have money. So this is what the challenge is about, how to get better clients in 30 days. I also want to tell you about my paid social media course. This is a social media fast start, just as the name says, fast start your social media in 5 days. So 5 days, 5 1-hour lessons. We cover everything you need to know in social media. It's enough to get you started. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm teaching you how to fish. It's excellent for those business owners, for coaches, for business coaches, mentors, for people who want to scale their social media. If you're using social media for a while and you're just getting tickets, you're just not getting the results you want, then this course is for you. It's 5 1-hour lessons. It's guided. It's a guided course. It's a blended learning. So I train you online, but there's also homework to be done. There's accountability. There's group coaching. It's 5 hours, so it's 1 hour a day, and you have access to the recordings. You have also get access to me for 2 hours coaching for a strategy call where we can build your strategy, your social media strategy step by step. So go to social medias with the S at the end, .co.za. So social media with the S at the end, .co.za. Social medias, it stands for social media success. So the word social medias doesn't exist, but the S stands for success. So go to my site and sign up. Guys, social media is reciprocal. So the social media challenge. 8 ways you can support small businesses. If you are a business owner, or you know somebody who is a business owner, somebody who's opened up a Facebook page, somebody who is starting up Facebook, starting up doing something, maybe they were retrenched, maybe they lost their job or whatever because of the times we live in. There's ways you can support them. Go and be proactive, guys. Be proactive. You can go and write a positive review. It's free of charge. Tell your friends and family, free of charge. Follow them on social media, free of charge. Engage with their post. Give them a shout out. Sign up for their newsletter. Okay, when it says sign, engage with their post, don't just go and just like the post. Do more. Comment. Tag a friend. Share it. Listen, because a like doesn't mean much. A like doesn't really carry a lot of weight. So I don't understand why people just like. Guys, if you want to do something, do it intentionally. 4 ways to use social media for good instead of evil. Be helpful without expecting something in return. Be reciprocal. Be present. Set it and forget it isn't the aim. Be social. That's what it's about. So guys, okay, listen, guys, one of the drawbacks of working from home is your neighbor's dogs. So if you can hear the dogs barking, that's so I live, both my neighbors on either side have a dog, and I think the dogs are in love with each other. So what they do is they communicate over my house. So if you're hearing dogs, it's the neighbor's dogs. So the challenge is find 5 friends' business pages, like and share their page, like, comment, and share on their posts, leave them a review, give them a shout out. So an idea for a shout out would be share their page to your Facebook, but when you're sharing it to your Facebook, write something in the comment, in the caption. Say something around the lines like, hey, check out this new hip and up and coming doggy parlor, something like that. Give them a shout out. So this is where the actual social breakfast starts. What's the most valuable currency in the world? Watch it. much. Thank you. So guys, there's a reason I showed you that video. There's a reason I showed you the most valuable currency today is attention. Attention is the most valuable currency today. That's where all our time is going, on our smartphones, on our computers, online, on screen, screen time. Screen is getting all our attention. Guess how often you use your phone every day? How often, how many times you look at your mobile? How many times you unlock your mobile? So research says we unlock our phones 30 times a day, but we know it's more like 300 times, maybe 300 to 600 times a day we unlock our phones. I think our cell phones are an attachment to our hands. It's an extension to our arm. That's how much we use our cell phone. Now, there's a reason I'm sharing the stats with you. Guess how long you use your phone every day? This is in hours. How many hours do you use your phone?
A woman was seriously injured in New Jersey when she tripped over an open cellar door and then tumbled into the basement. The 67-year-old woman was looking at her cell phone when she flipped headfirst into the basement about 6 feet below. Fire crews rescued the woman and took her to the hospital.
Hectic, guys. Listen here, hectic. So this happened to us where we bumped into things. When we go onto our cell phones, we just lose. We become subconscious. I mean, we lose concentration when we go on our cell phones. So that we need to capture our market because they are in their phones. So we can meet them where they are at in their playground on their mobile devices. That's why I'm sharing this with you. Now, this is digital stats. This is 2020. This is January 2020. The population is 7.8 billion. 4.2 billion social media users, 4.6 billion internet users. The growth from last year, 1%. I'm actually surprised with all the lockdowns and people staying at home that the population only grew by 1%. But look at this. Social media grew by 13.2%. In SA, the population grew to 59 million. There's 100 SIM card mobile connections. That means that 100 SIM cards, that means that almost everybody has two cell phones. The active social media users is 25 million. The population grew by 1.3%, but look at social media in SA, grew by 13.6%. Look at that, guys. That means that social media is growing drastically. So, the population grew by 3 million from last year in SA. Of that 25 million people who use social media, 98% of them access to their smartphone. If you are marketing to a millennial audience between the ages of 18 and 35, you need a serious social media strategy. WhatsApp is the most used platform in the country. So just to explain to you the difference between a social media platform and a social media channel. A social media channel is like Facebook, is like a network. It's like where people can follow you, they can like you, they can comment. On the other hand, a channel is a WhatsApp is like a channel, meaning that it's a messenger. It's one-to-one, like Facebook Messenger, Snapchat. Those are all channels. Sorry, those are platforms. Those are platforms. The social media channel is your network, like your Facebook. Sorry about that. That was my robot response. So guys, now we're gonna get into some juicy meat stuff of this call. So how to set up a one-click WhatsApp link in your email signature so your customers can contact you easily. So the tools you need a WhatsApp generator link. So go to the site, create.wa.link. That's the name of the link that will generate your WhatsApp link. And then we need our email program, Gmail or Outlook. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back to that. I'm going to continue with the lesson and I'm going to come back to that and show you how to do it. So this is the objective of the call, content ideas. This is the main objective of our daily calls. So every day I will give you new ideas. Every day I will give you new strategies. And the reason being that sometimes we want to be told what to do, or sometimes we just want to be reminded. So that's the purpose of this call. The purpose of this call is massive action, for you to take massive action. But you also need a strategy when it comes to action, to that. You don't want to take massive action in the wrong direction. So make sure you've got a plan before you start taking action. So today we're talking content ideas. So it's April. What happens this month? So Easter just happened now. There were a lot of family get-togethers, a lot of selfies taken, a lot of memories made. So now that Easter is over, ask your users for UGC, user-generated content. User-generated content is powerful content. It's content that your users, your fans, your followers, your customers submit to you. And why it's powerful is because they're actually endorsing you, one, and two, you're tapping into their network as well. If ever you've posted on Facebook, on your Facebook business page, you know that only 1% of your followers will see your post. So when you post UGC, it shows that you are human and people are actually interacting with your brand. So this is, if you go to Valentine's, if you go to Instagram and you search Valentine's, this is examples of UGC. Another, if you want ideas, content ideas on what to post on your social media on a monthly basis, go to this government site, the South African government site. It's called derco.gov.za, and every month they give you a breakdown of what's happening. So the theme for April is Freedom Month. So you can create all your posts around freedom in April. These are all the public holidays. You can create posts for the public holidays, International Mother Earth Day, World Book and Copyright Day, World Intellectual Property Day, Freedom Day. You can create posts around it. If you click on each one of these links, it'll give you more information and you can copy and paste that information into your posts. But my advice to you is always credit the source. Another good site is the teacherscorner.net. TheTeachersCorner.net. I forgot to put that link on the screen. Every month they give you a calendar and they tell you exactly what's happening. So today is Tuesday. The North Pole was discovered. So maybe you can create a post around the North Pole. Hey, tomorrow, look at tomorrow. Tomorrow is no housework day. And World Health Day is tomorrow. And look at Saturday, Encourage a Young Writer Day. National Sibling Day. So Saturday is National Sibling Day. I think that's for the States. But listen, maybe you can create a post and say, hey guys, National Sibling Day. Another good site to get content, daily content, is history.com. History.com will give you content for every single day. Look at this. In 1896, the first modern Olympic Games was held. You can create something around that. Wikipedia is also a good site to get content. Look at this. Keep it positive, guys. Just keep it positive. Don't put negative stuff. See, this guy, whatever his name is, Yobomir Kipov, is considered the founders of Bulgarian's modern professional musical instrument. Maybe create something around music. You know, it's important. People love stuff like music, TV, films, popular culture. You can create. So how I'm saying you to use this content is come into this into these repositories. Get the content. Open your Canva or your Photoshop and recreate this content. I'm not asking you to copy and paste. I'm asking you to recreate it. Recreate it using your own branding, your logo, your own images. And always credit the source. If you're the lazy social media manager, you can go to brainycode.com and get the quote. This is a good quote for the day. You can just come and share it to your social media. Just click on the social media buttons below and you can just share it instead of creating it. Another good site to get content ideas is Pinterest.com. Pinterest, guys, I'm not asking you to come here and copy. I'm asking you to recreate, get ideas and inspiration. So just to elaborate, what's UGC? User-generated content stands for user. It's where your fans and your followers submit content to you. So this is a couple that was recently engaged. They submitted the engagement ring. Look here. They got so much of engagement. So many people told them congrats. They got 134 likes. So that's what UGC is all about, sharing in other people's experiences. This is a bride who submitted her wedding photograph for Father's Day. This is a Starbucks UGC where the customers of Starbucks colored in their cup and submitted it. This is my own UGC where I visited the Lion Park and took a picture and I submitted it and it was shared on social media. This is a Vans social media UGC. And guys, some tips I can give you for social media. Use humor. Funny memes work well on social media. Stay away from controversial topics like religion, politics, racism, abortion, causes and rights. Just remain neutral. Even on your personal profile, remain neutral. Use the daily hashtag. So today is Tuesday. Yes, guys, it's Tuesday today. So use a Tuesday hashtag. Find a hashtag that you like. So whatever hashtag you're using, make sure that it is relevant to your post. So you can post maybe a good idea would be to post that story about the Bulgarian music guy and then say Tuesday tune. Maybe pick one of his tunes and speak about that in your post. So that's the content ideas. Just to remind you, the free challenge that starts on the 1st of May. Guys, invite your friends to take the challenge. It's free of charge. And you also have the opportunity to network with each other, with people, and share your ideas. Even if you've got any social media, digital marketing questions, bring it on and we'll answer it live and we can address it. If you see this on Facebook, share it. And guys, that's all for my presentation, but I want to show you how to create the WhatsApp button and how to create the WhatsApp button. So first, what you're going to do is you're going to go to create WhatsApp link. Go to the site, create WhatsApp link. You can even Google it. You can just say WhatsApp link. So it must be wa.link. You come to the site, you'll see a create WhatsApp link. Click on that button. Type in your phone number in there. Make sure that you got the right flag. Type in your phone number in there. I'm typing my number there. Right. Then below is a custom message. Watch on the right. I can say, hello, put in a nice emoji. Let's put a nice emoji. I like this one. Let's put this one right. Add the emoji there. Say, yes, send me more information. Thanks. Right. And then you click on it. This is the preview. This is what it looks like. So then you click generate link, generate my WhatsApp link. It opens up this. So you can save this. You can save this QR code. You can put this on your flyers, your marketing, and you can copy this link. So what I do is I right click and I say copy link address, right? Now there's a reason I do that, because if I just copy this, it's not going to copy the HTTPS, www. So just to test the link first, what I do is I click on the plus and I paste it in there. Make sure that your link https://// and it's got this exactly. So this is your link, your WhatsApp link. You're going to save this link. You're going to save it somewhere, whether in a notepad or a Word document. Because you can put this link anywhere going forward. You can put this link anywhere. Anybody clicks on this link, they'll be able to send you an instant WhatsApp message. Next step is you can either come and you can either create a link that's a text link. A hyperlink is a, so just to explain to you what a hyperlink is. A hyperlink is a link on the internet or on your in your email signature. You can either use a text link or you can use an image link. So let's look for a WhatsApp chat button. Just go to Google and search and click on images and look for a nice button that you like. So what I do is I come here and I will say on the image, right click and save image. I'm gonna save that image on my desktop. Right, so I've already got the image and I've got the link. I've got the WhatsApp link. So remember, I've got the WhatsApp link. So first, let me show you how to create the WhatsApp link in Outlook. So open your Outlook. This is your Outlook. The process on Outlook will be the same, will be similar whether you're using Outlook 2003, Outlook 1997, Outlook 2019, the process is the same. So you click on the File menu, you click on Options, you click on Mail, you click on Signatures, right? So these are all the signatures that I've created already. You're gonna create a new signature. You're gonna click on New, and you're gonna say, you can call it whatever, WhatsApp chat button. Right, so this is it. Then this is where you're gonna put your content in, and this is where you're gonna choose your account. So I'm gonna make sure you're in the right account. So I've got many accounts. I'm gonna choose Yashtek, message to new messages from Yashtek, replies to Yashtek. Now this is very important because if you don't select this, people won't see the signature. But for this lesson, I'm just going to, let's change that. In fact, let's change that. This is important. So make sure you're in the right account and make sure that you are new messages using this signature that we created now and replies as well. So here you're going to type in, you can change the font. You can make it bold. You can change the colors. You can align. You can add your business card. This here is to add an image to this area. And this here is to add a hyperlink. So first you just type in some information, maybe telephone 081-714-6525, enter email info at yashtek.co.za. And then as I hit enter, automatically becomes a link. Then what chat, I'm gonna say something like this. Start a chat on WhatsApp. Right, and then click here. So I'm gonna show you two ways of how to link this button now. So what you do is you select the text and you click on this button, the hyperlink button, this one with the globe and the link, you click on it. You're gonna link to, leave it default, existing web page, leave everything default. And at the bottom where it says address, you're gonna paste that in there. And then you're gonna say, okay, right. Now you have linked that link, WhatsApp link, right? Now let me show you how to link a picture, that button that we downloaded. So I'm gonna click on this picture button, this button here, this icon. I'm gonna go in, find this download button, this one. Select it. Let's see if it allows me to resize. It's not allowing me to resize, but it's fine. Click on it once, and then click on this hyperlink button again. And then in there, you're going to paste, okay, and okay, and then okay. Make sure you click okay 3 times. Now to test it, let me test it to myself. So I'm gonna click new email. Send it to myself. Test. So now signature. Now this is happening because I chose the wrong signature, but by default in that settings, and I'm sure you can go back and watch the recording to change that. Click on signature, and I'm gonna choose WhatsApp button. There's a button there. There's the stuff, the signature that's created. You can go wild with the signature. I mean, let me show you what I did earlier. This is what I did in the morning. You can create this in, I created this in the same way. You're just gonna go and choose WhatsApp button, and I'm gonna say send. Oh, cancel. and send. Right. So now I'm going to go to my Gmail and look for that. Look for that. There's it there. Now, there's it there. If I click on it, it opens up to WhatsApp. Can you see it opens up in WhatsApp? I can do that as well. Opens up in WhatsApp. Right. So now let me show you how to do this on Gmail. So this is my Gmail. Click on, log on to your Gmail. On the top, click on settings. Click on see all settings. Scroll to the bottom and find signature. Click on create new WhatsApp chat button and create. Then we're going to say, you're going to add in there telephone 0817146525. Then I'm going to say chat link and I'm going to paste that in there. That's one way. Or I can select this text. Let's say click here. Click here. And then select this link icon that's there. And in here, you paste that, right? You paste this link, right? And then we can add a, we can add a picture. To add a picture, you can add the, click on this insert image. You can click on upload, select file from device. Let's choose that one there. There's it there, it appears there. Right, select it and then click on the link button again and paste it in there and okay. And now I can make sure you select the right email signature, click save changes and then click new email. Let's send this to Gmail test and I'm going to say send. Open it. There's a test file there. There's a chat button. Click on it. Opens up in WhatsApp. And yeah, so guys, that's how you create a WhatsApp button and that's how you link your WhatsApp button to your email signature. So you learned a lot of things today. Go back and watch this video a couple times and you'll get the process of how to create a WhatsApp link and include it into your email signature. So you learned how to create an email signature. You learned about how to go and insert a picture in your email signature. You learned on Gmail, you learned on your Outlook as well. So there's no excuse for you not to have a cool signature. Anyway, guys, see you guys tomorrow. Share this with your mates. If you see this on Facebook, share it with your mates. Remember the challenge and love you guys lots. And well done. And thank you for attending. See you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.